Hi everyone, Peter Wolf here from Azamba Consulting Group. And today we're going to talk about how to modify a screen within Sage CRM. This is a pretty common thing to do to make sure that your screens are optimized for your users. You're not showing too many fields. You've got the right fields in place and you've got them in the right order. So before we get started there, let's just talk quickly about who is Azamba Consulting Group. We've been around since 2007 and we've helped 400 small, medium-sized companies get up and running successfully with CRM. And most of those customers are Sage accounting system integrated. So if you have a Sage 100, Sage 300, or Sage X3 system, we can help you get integrated and up and running with your sales team. We focus on your success. And in fact, we back that with 100% money back guarantee. So if you're looking for great quality, dependable help, give us a call. So let's talk about today's agenda. So we are going to be talking about modifying the screen, and my bit of advice for anybody who's going to modify a screen, whether it's customizing the screen or doing other things, is back up your system. So either back up your system, do a fresh database backup, or do this in a sandbox before you do it in your live system. It's for your protection, and if, in case something goes wrong, you can always fall back to the default point, the backup point. So today we're going to talk about accessing the customization area, how to get in there, what rights you need to have, finding how to find the correct screen. There's a lot of screens in the system, so how do you find the right one to customize? We'll discuss moving, positioning, adding, replacing fields. We're going to be talking about working with the scripts. So there's field level scripts. You can control how fields show up on the screen in the first place, but also how what things happen when they change, what kind of automations, what kind of cascade effects happen. So we're going to talk about those things as well. And then we're going to talk about building mobile screens. So, you know, a lot of times these days, mobile is super important for all of us. So we're going to discuss how to get a nice looking mobile screen and what your options are there for that. So with that said, let's get started. Okay, we're in our Sage CRM system, and let's say we want to customize this company screen. So let's just say, for sake of argument, we want to remove the segment. And we want to add in a customer ID field. So we're going to go ahead and do that. So the first thing you need to know is you need to have the security permission to do so. You need to be able to see under this profile menu here, when you click it, you're going to need to see this administration. So if you don't have this administrative rights, you'll either need to log in as an administrator equivalent or make sure that your administrator gives you permission to do this. Assuming that you have those rights, if you have problems with that, like I said before, give us a call. We'll be able to help you with that, or call your partner that you currently use. They'll be able to help you with that. But we'll go into administration section. Once you're in administration, there's a few options over here on the side. They also show up here in the middle. I'm going to go ahead and pick customization, because that's what we want to do, is customize that screen. And you're going to note right away that literally any area that you go into in the system is customizable. So primary entities are usually those entities that are the key core entities, such as communications, opportunities, companies, people, the contacts, and the service tickets. And if you build any of your own custom entities that are also identified as primary, they might also show up here. If the entity, the area that you're looking for, that you want to change, isn't here, it should be listed under these secondary entities. So almost every area in the system is customizable. Again, if you have a problem, feel free to give us a call. But for now, we're going to go ahead and pick the company screen. And once you're in this customization area, there's all sorts of things that you can do, and we'll save those for future videos. But for now, we want to modify the screens. So one of the common questions is, well, which screen do I want to modify? Because there's a few screens, and unless you've been working with the system a lot, it's kind of hard to figure out which one is the one you want to use, right? So Sage has built this little thing called Inline Customization. You check this box, and what this does is it changes the front end interface. So if I go back to American Business Features, I can see this new thing has been set up right here, customized screen. And if I click this, it's actually going to pull up the screen customization for that screen. And you can kind of see company name, type, status is in here. So all these fields are there. This is definitely that screen. So the first thing I want to talk about is positioning fields. So as you can see from the layout, the way I envision it is it's almost like a spreadsheet. There's invisible rows and columns on these screens.
So you can position things to sit inside of a row and a column, but you can also make things expand beyond a curtain, a certain specific row or a specific column. So you could make things take up more space vertically or horizontally as you choose. And let's just quickly pull that back up and I'll show you how you do that. So for example, let's just say you wanted to do something simple. I'm not sure you'd want to do this, but just for our sake, let's just make the type field take up two columns. You would find the type field in this list. You can see its position is the same line as the record before it. And there's the height and the width. So I'm just going to make this two columns and I'm going to hit update and I'm going to hit save. And now when this screen refreshes, you can see it move the website over into that fourth column. And the type now is taken up two columns. Now this isn't a very practical example because you probably wouldn't need to have type take up two columns, but let's just say you had a description field and you might want to take up multiple rows, multiple columns, just to give it more breathing room so that it fits better on your screen. That's a very common thing to do. So let's go back into the screen because I also mentioned I wanted to hide segment. And actually I changed my mind. I'm gonna hide employees. So I'm gonna come in here. First, I'm going to put the type back to one column. Have to hit update. If you don't hit update, it will not save your changes. So you want to remember to do that. And now I want to just remove the employees. So it's pretty simple. You just hit the remove button. The employees is now gone. If I hit save, it's going to update. And you can see now employees is gone. And so this leads us to our next exercise, which is adding a field in. So let's add a field back in. Let's add employees back in. So I would just hit customize. I would find that field in this list here. So the fields are usually the name, the caption that you see on the screen. Sometimes you'll see more computerese talk like comp underscore, TTY, whatever. That's a field that generally doesn't show up on the screen. So you probably wouldn't want to use that field. But like most of the other fields, any kind of field, any kind of data that you want to see, it shows up with its English caption, so it's pretty easy to find. I'm going to pick employees, and I'm going to hit add. By default, it puts it at the bottom of the screen. And so I'm just going to save this, and I'll show you what it does. It's set to the same line as the record before it, so I'm going to hit save. And what this did is you can see it just added employees down here. And of course, that's not where we want it, but it's a good example of kind of what happens when you add a field in, it automatically puts it at the bottom. I want to make a quick change here and I'll show you what happens if you make that go onto a new line. As you'd imagine, what this is saying is make this a new line. Don't continue the same line as before. So when I hit update and save, you're going to see employees now is on its own line down here. So that new line can be nice because you can break and lay out the screens and start new lines with fields to your heart's content. So right now I'm going to move that back to the same line. And I'm just going to move that field up. And so you just use these arrows to move it up or down as you see fit. I'm going to go ahead and put it right next to the revenue field again, where it was before. I'm going to hit update, save, and we can look at our handiwork. And there it is. It's back to where it was, just like you'd expect. So pretty easy to add fields in here. And we'll have another video on how to actually add new data fields. So if there's fields that you want to add, so if there's certain pieces of data that you track that's important to your business that aren't listed here, there's ways in Sage CRM to add those in. So you'll be able to do that, and I'll show you that in a different video. For now, what I want to do is focus on what the field scripts are. So you'll see there's three different, these are called field scripts, create, on change, and validate. And essentially what these are ways to programmatically control what's going on in the screen. And so in some cases, on create, for example, before the screen shows up, what do you want to do with that field? So you could hide that field. So if someone is not a manager, maybe they don't see that field. If it's not their account, maybe the field comes in as read only. So they can only see it, but they can't edit it because it's not their account. They're not the salesperson associated with that customer. On change is it just what you'd think. If I change the value of this field to X, then make something else happen. Usually you can use that for cascading drop-down. So if it's a customer of this type, so it's a certain industry, then maybe some sub-options show up. And maybe other sub-options are hidden away. So you can control kind of what happens to the screen based on what a certain field value is. And then validate, again, just like you'd expect, validate is the rules that allow this record to be saved. So for example, if you have a phone number field and you would want to validate that, you'd want to say it has to be 10 characters long, not including the hyphens and the parentheses. And if someone puts in a phone number that only has 7 digits, it could put a big red X next to that field when they hit the save button and say, hey, you need to put a full phone number in. So you can control your data flow, you can control your data input, and make sure that the data is correct before it gets saved. So that's a great way of using validate script. The power of that is obvious, and it really allows you to make sure that your data not only is useful, but it gets put in correctly. The custom content script, and this is more advanced stuff, so not a lot of our customers will do this, but if you're more of a programmer type for both the create, on-change, and validate scripts, but also for the custom content allows you to take more control over the screen universally. So you could create some functions where it pops up another window, or maybe it pops up a map of the customer's records. So you can do all sorts of really cool advanced customization. I'm not going to go into that. This session was mostly directed towards beginners, but if you're interested in learning more about the custom content field, the help box is really good. A lot of people don't take advantage of the Sage CRM help, but you can use the help. We'll also have another video on our website, azamba.com/sage, that goes into other resources that you can tap into to kind of understand these things. There's a lot of great content about how to build out custom content and control your experience. And of course, you can always reach out to us. The last thing I wanted to cover here today was mobile screens. And so when I hit customize screen here, it's going into what's called the HTML screen. That's the screen that you see in your browser. That's what we all are used to. But if I go back to that administration area, you'll see here, you can create screens for different devices. And so with these screens, you'll get a list of, I'm sorry, with these device choices, you'll get a list of the screens that are available on those devices. And so for a mobile phone, you can already see, I'll go back and I'll show you, but the number of fields on a mobile phone is less. And that makes sense because you have less room on a mobile phone. And so you really want to make sure that the mobile experience is more tailored towards the key critical fields. You don't want to overwhelm your people with a lot of fluff. So you can really restrict that. And so you can do the same thing that I just showed you on the main screen, on the HTML screen. You can do that on a mobile screen. So one thing you'll note though, is a lot of times the mobile screens will lay it out just all, everything's on its own row. So you don't have fields on the same row. There just isn't enough room on the phone interface. So you don't have to worry as much about the positioning to kind of lay out the screen. So that's nice. But so just a real quick comparison, I'm gonna go pull up that screen again. So this is the search screen here. It actually might be the same. And here it is on, yeah, it's different. So here's the search screen on the mobile device. So it's different. It is less fields because there's less room. So that's it for today. I just really wanted to cover the experience of customizing screen. It's pretty easy. Once you've done it once or twice, it's pretty easy to get the hang of it. But if you have any questions, please reach out to us. And if you're just evaluating Sage CRM, let us know. We can give you a personalized one-on-one demonstration and answer any questions you might have. Hope this was entertaining and useful. Talk to you soon. Bye.